the last movement of Mozart's Serenade No. 13, Eine kleine Nachtmusik, A Little Night Music. Otto Klemperer conducting the strings of the Philharmonia Orchestra in 1956. It had been a very long time since he had been as fulfilled in his career as he was now. With an orchestra of the Philharmonia's calibre, his rehearsals were no longer the tussles they had been in earlier times, and he was altogether more economical in his comments, although that did not mean that he was any less demanding.
He knew what he wanted. He had certain things which he was very, very emphatic about, such as in the Eroica and some of the other symphonies, where it's pianissimo. He would cut the orchestra down to the front three desks, and then the others were tacit, so that you could play it with a warm, lovely sound. And then after those so many bars, the whole string section would then come in. So, of course, you heard the difference immediately, but you got that wonderful pianissimo with a sound, because he was very, very, very dedicated to the kind of sound that was produced.
There was nearly always a very solid togetherness in the playing for Klemperer, and that came out of his inexorable rhythm, as former Philharmonia Orchestra members Basil Tschaikov and Martyn Jones explain.
His whole body had rhythm in it. So that movement of his little finger, all those twiddles and what looked like vague movements, the moment where there was a beat that needed to be there, he was one of the most precise of conductors.
A really sound rhythm is so enormous that it just can't be knocked off course. Nobody can upset it. It's just there. It's like fate. And once he set a rhythm, there was no question about it, and everybody felt it and went along with it.
His whole style of conducting was utterly natural, utterly simple, and above all, I suppose one could say, his pulse, which was absolutely perfect, so simple and so natural that everything was together.
He had this wonderful pulse that went through music the whole time, and it was electrifying.
This recording of Beethoven's Ninth Symphony was perhaps the most celebrated of all Klemperer's discs, and it remains one of the most famous of all recordings ever made. When it was released in 1958, quite a number of music critics acclaimed it with the same word, monumental.